Hey friends and everyone, welcome back to this channel. In this video, we are going to talk about logging in .NET 8 Blazor and also .NET 8 Web API. If today is the first time of you hearing logging, then maybe what will come to your mind here is, what is logging? How useful it is? In this video, we are going to cover these two guys. Before we jump right into this, make sure you're subscribed to this channel and also turn on the notification bell to receive updates as soon as I upload new content. Now, logging is the practice of recording events, messages, or information during execution of software application. It serves several important purposes. It can help you in debugging and also troubleshooting your software. It helps you in monitoring and also diagnostics, auditing and compliance, and also for security reasons. Let's say when you create an application, you run the application in a development mode and you have an exception. You want to log it. You want to keep that record or that exception so you can refer to it later on, read, and also find a way to solve this. That is where logging comes in. There are types of logging. We have application logs, we have system logs, we have security logs, and also for performance logs. And also, there are logs levels. Now, in logging in your application, there are levels that you can use. Basically, there are 6 levels. We can have a look at debug. You can log as info. You can log as warning. You can log as error. You can log as critical. And you can log as fatal. So these are the 6 types of errors that you can log in your application. Now, these log levels cut across in Blazor and also Web API. Aside from this, there are some frameworks that you can use to log, such as nlog, serilog, and etc. In the future videos, we cover a video on how to include serilog and nlog in the application. But for now, we are going to work on the default logging service provided by Microsoft in Blazor or in .NET Web API. Let's have a project created. So when you check my solution, I have a solution created and I've added 2 projects. One is a Web API and also one is Blazor application. And that is this. So in default, Microsoft provides logger service for both projects. Let's see, how do you use this logger service to log messages to the console? This logger service actually logs messages to the console. So we can use it in both the Blazor application and also the web application. Before we integrate the logger, let's try to run each application and check it out. So this is a Blazor app. I'll try to run this Blazor app. Now each project that you run has a console that gets started with it. And that is where we want to display all an errors from the application. So you can see that there is a command prompt and that gets started as soon as you run the application. And so when you log any error to the console, it can be displayed in here, or it can also be displayed from the output window. You can also display it in here. So let's see how to use the default login service in here. Let's say we have a button as a counter, and now if I click on this, I want to log an information down here. Okay, now put in mind that there are levels of logs. We have information, debug, warning, error, critical, fatal, etc. So we're going to log information to the user or to the console. So let's close this up. Let's go to our solution. Then in here, from our Blazor application, you go to the component, pages, now counter. So within this one, if you want to use a logger service in here, we have to inject it. So let's inject ILogger. This is an interface and it takes in a T value. And now this T value here is going to be the counter. That is a component. And let's say this is counter. Logger. So with this, let's see, as soon as I click on this button, you know, we have a button in here. As soon as I click on this button, I want to log. So what I'm going to do here is just counter logger dot. Now you see here we have a lot of these are the log levels. We have log error, information, trace, warning, and etc. Debug critical. So let's log information. And now here, what we need to do here is specify the information that we want to log. So let's say so counter button is clicked. Let's save this. And now let's run this application and click on that button and check it out. So the app is now running. Let's click on that button and check it out. So from this, we have our console, as you can see from here. Now this is also our counter button. So I'm going to click on this. And as soon as I click on this counter, we must have a log message here. Check it out. So you can see counter button is clicked. If I click on it again, counter button is clicked. You see that? So that is a way to log messaging here. And here we are using a log level of what information. You can also change this in case you want to display it as an error. You can also check this as error. Let's say we have a counter button in here, and then we want to use try catch block to get an error in here and now log it to the console. Alright, so here I have an HTTP client injected in here, as you can see, an instance has been created. Now, in the button click method, this is what we did, first one. And now here, we just have to surround it with the try catch block. And we are getting a response from this get async from this API. Although this API does not exist, but we are passing in here so we can catch an exception. Now in here, we also want to get a result, and all these are going to give us an exception. So when we run this, we're going to have an exception, and in that, we want to log it as log error. We pass in the message. This is going to log to the console. So let's run this and check it out. So if I pull out my console, you see from here that I have it. Now I'm going to click on counter. Then if I click on the button, check what's going to happen. So we have an exception and it failed. As you can see, an invalid request URL was provided. So here we're able to log this an exception to this. Now if I put a breakpoint in here, let's click on this again from the UI and now check it from that end. So from this exception, an invalid request URL was provided and it's the same thing in here. So in this case, we're able to log this message to the screen or to the console. That's fine. What if you want to specify the parameter to this log? Let's assume with this we can comment this. In order to provide parameter for the log, what we're going to do here is you have to specify this string formatting. So here you want to grab the current count from this. At the end of the day, we want to increase it by 1. And on here, as soon as you click on this button, we want to specify the current count, display this in the console, and also pass in this. And now this string formatting that we're doing is going to be affected by the first parameter that we specified in here. So the current count, that is this. Okay. So here, if you want to specify another one, let's say you want to specify another one, another parameter, maybe we can also have a look at. So previous, then previous, we're going to say this is previous. And now in here, this is going to be the second one. So you're going to say current count minus 1. Okay. So let's say you can see this is going to pick the first one here, and that is going to be picked by the second one. So in order to do this, we want to get it. So maybe we can put this in bracket so we can subtract it before we display. Okay, now let's run this application and check it out. So let's see, click on this counter, and we have our click on this counter, and now in here, we have click me. So you see we have the current count is 0. Now previous is minus 1, so it's negative 1. Click on the again. Now current count is 1, previous is 0. And I can see we're able to provide parameters to this. So using default login service for Microsoft, very simple. All that you need to do here is to inject it into the ILogger, passing the property of that is the component, create an instance of it, and I can use it to log all the log levels such as information, critical, fatal, error, warning, and etc. I can do it. Okay, now let's have a look on how to use it in the web API too. If you want to log to the console from the web API, how are you going to do this? So you can see from here we have our weather forecast controller. And now with this controller, there's a class. When you open the controller's folder, we have a weather forecast controller. Defaultly, we have this ILogger service injected for us, and it has been initialized in our constructor. All that you need to do here is to pick it up and now use it. How do you do that? So let's say when this class gets started, in this we want to log. So we're going to do here is logger dot, you can see we have log. Now with this log, you can specify the log level in here. So dot is information, and in that you can specify your message. Okay, so forecast started. That is when we have the constructor being called, forecast started. And now if I call this get message, I can also have this logger dot here. I want can use a straightforward log information, and I'm going to say that weather forecast list called. And now at the end here, if I want to display the list that we have, I can just create, so let's say list is equal to enumerable of this, then at the end I'm going to return this list. But before I return this list, I want to log this. So log information, and now with this information I'm going to say that weather forecast list. So weather forecast list is equal to this, and I'm going to provide list. Okay, and at the end here I'll provide this list itself. So it's the same thing, we are using this string and formatting, then we pass in the real parameter. Okay, that's the variable that you want to display. All right, so it could be, this is log information, it could be warning, it could be any other log level. Very simple. Now let's also run this and check it out. So before we run this application, let's check, let's make this as a length, because you want to get the list or the length of this list, the number of items that we have in this list. So we want to specify this, and we can change this to count. So this doesn't matter the name that you specified in here. As soon as you have it in the position, it's going to pick the first one, and that'll be all. Okay, so now let's run this and see. When we click on this get weather forecast, we must have this log information displayed on top, and we must have this beneath, and this must specify the length of this. Now let's see, let's wait for this app to get launched. We click on the button, so that is this one. We have our console also available. Now with this, click on try this out, and now we must have something like forecast started, and at the end weather forecast list, we have it is up to 5. When you check our list itself, we must have 5 in there. Yeah, so you can see that using this default logger service is very simple, done by Microsoft. All that you need to do here is to create an instance. If it is a Blazor application, inject it and we use it. If it is a web API, it has already injected for you. So you can also make a duplicate of it in the other controllers, have an instance of it, and now use it. This is very simple. But in case you want to log it to a file, a TST file, how is it done? We have a video on that next time. So for now, thank you, and I'm going to catch you up in the next video.